Hey, 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 how is it going again, Guardians? LV Native here with another Destiny video. Today's video, we are going to be taking a look at a fantastic build that you could run on your Stormcallers in order to wreak havoc upon your competition. Now, as you could probably tell from clicking on that thumbnail, this is what I like to refer to as the Palpatine build. Basically, with this build, you're going to be chucking out so much lightning from your hands that it's going to make Emperor Palpatine suffer from a little bit of force envy on the dark side, of course. But before we get into that, let's go ahead and take a look at
the feature comment of the day.
Now, today's comment comes to us from Devin Campano, and it says, I should be the feature comment of the day because I watch your channel with my son and he loves you. Keep up the good work, and I'm the first comment. Yes, you were, Devin. You absolutely are correct. So remember, guys, if you want to be on the featured comment of the day, all you got to do is smack that like button on this video and leave a comment in the section, and I just might pick yours to be the next featured comment of the day. So let's go ahead and jump right into the build for my Stormcaller for all you Warlocks out there. As you can see right away, I have my armor and recovery stats pretty high up there. I don't care about agility as much. I want to be able to get my health back and be able to take as much damage as I possibly can. One thing about the Stormcaller, it loves getting up close to people, and this extra armor and recovery gives you the survivability to be able to do so. For our grenades, first up we have the Pulse Grenade, a grenade that periodically damages enemies that are inside its explosion radius. Now, as you can see right here, this has a fairly decent AoE. It covers a decent amount of ground. And if you get this in a congested choke point that has a few enemies in it, it can definitely dole out a decent amount of damage. However, it is usually not my first choice of grenades whenever I run the Stormcaller. Next up for grenades, we have got the Storm Grenade, a grenade that calls down a focused lightning storm. Now, this is one of my favorites to run when I'm running the Stormcaller, as you can actually see the AoE on this grenade is quite large, and it can hit a surprisingly large amount of people at one time. This is a very good grenade to throw into choke points and congested areas, or on control points to, you know, stop people from capping that control point. It is phenomenal. It's a great zoning grenade, but if they're all clumped together, it can also dole out a bunch of damage to the enemy. Our third and final grenade to choose from is the Arc Bolt Grenade, a grenade that chains bolts of lightning to nearby enemies. If this looks familiar to any of you hunters out there, it should. This is the exact same grenade that they have on the Blade Dancer subclass. So, if you are familiar with that grenade, then you are familiar with this one. It is a decent AoE grenade that will be able to lock onto a couple of targets at the same time and chain lightning damage to them. This, again, is not bad to be able to throw behind corners and things to get the enemy rattled, get them to leave out of their cover, and then you gun them down as they run. It also does a decent amount of damage as well. Out of the three grenades, I would say run with the Storm Grenade, as I think it just has the best damage and overall utility of most of the grenades. For your glide, you can pick whichever one you like here. You got Focused Control, Focused Burst, and Balanced Glide. I highly recommend going with Focus Burst. It gives you a little initial speed boost when you first go ahead and activate it, and if you master the bunny hop with the Warlock, you can actually move around not quite as fast as Titans can when they're skating, but you can actually come pretty close, which is why I don't need my agility too high on this build. Go with the Focus Burst, learn how to do that Warlock bunny hop, and you will be moving around that lightning speeds. For your Storm Trance, you got a couple of good options here. You have Landfall. On casting Storm Trance, fire a bolt of lightning onto the ground, creating a devastating shockwave under you. This can be pretty situational, but if you can catch the right group of people, as soon as you go ahead and use your super ability, you will go ahead and kill a couple people right off the bat before you even land back onto the ground. And for that reason, this can be very useful in certain situations. Next up, we have the Superconductor. Double your Storm Trance's lightning chaining capabilities. Sounds cool, right? It actually performs in practice a little underwhelming, making you think that, you know, doubles your Storm Trance grenade's lightning chaining abilities. You will not be able to just chain one particular lightning bolt to a bunch of enemies. You'll be able to hit three, I think, four with Superconductor, but you're not going to get a giant jump in effectiveness out of it, and it's so situational that I just can't recommend using it, because we're going to be going with our third option, the Ionic Blink. Press L3 to teleport during Storm Trance. This is an invaluable tool, not only used as an escape tool when people are trying to, you know, team shot you down, because when they see a Stormcaller coming in, you're either going to try to run or the entire team is going to focus burst you down. Ionic Blink makes you very unpredictable and tough to target, lets you close that gap very quickly, and able to get your killing blow with your super, and then blink away onto the next victim. It is essential for this build, and I think it is by far the better choice out of the three. And for your melee, we have Thunderstrike. For the Thunderstrike, we can either go with Chain Lightning. Your Thunderstrike chains to other nearby enemies. This one sounds pretty good, but it doesn't do that much damage to the enemies that it chains to. Because of that, I don't think it is the strongest option. After that, you have Amplitude. Your Thunderstrike has greater range. Now the funny thing is, the Stormcaller already has a ridiculous amount of range with the Thunderstrike. Amplitude makes this like you're sniping people with your melee. I mean, that is only a slight exaggeration, people. You equip this with a shotgun, you can fire that shotgun from well outside the normal kill radius and polish them up with your melee, and you will be able to kill people from an entirely way too long range. So this is, I hate to say it, and I'm gonna probably regret recommending a lot of people use it, because I hate it when it happens to me, but out of the tools we have, Amplitude is by far gonna be the greatest melee for PvP. Rising Storm in your third column here, not bad, hits with the Thunderstrike, charges your super ability and your melee energy. It is only going to give a little bit of a charge to it, and it does not even come close to giving you that added benefit that the Amplitude does. So because of that, you already know, run with Amplitude. In this column right here, you can go to the Arcane Wisdom, Arcane Spear, Arcane Force. Again, suit these however you like. Me, I like to focus on armor and recovery, so I go with Arcane Spirit. And again, for that same reason, I go Divine Order. But go ahead and mix and match these as you like to suit your particular playstyle. In here, we have Pulse Wave. When critically wounded, trigger a Pulse Wave that boosts speed for you and your allies. This is very situational, but it can be used to great effect when you are needing to get you and your team out of harm's way quickly. So you hear a super coming and you get hurt by it, you can bolt out of there. The other team will not be able to catch up to you. You guys can reset and come back in for the kill. It is a pretty fun one to mess around with. Up next, you had Feedback. Incoming melee attacks fully recharge and intensify your Thunderstrike. Now this makes it sound like, hey, you just hit me, I'm gonna turn around and one-shot you. It'll still take 2 hits to kill your opponent, regardless if Feedback is triggered or not. Because of that, I cannot recommend it for PvP, because if it's not going to go ahead and one hit them, it doesn't give me the enough benefit when I can two hit them without it anyway. So because of that, we are going to go with Transcendence. Now, when you cast your super with full grenade and melee energy, your Storm Trance restores your health to full and it drains slower. I'm going to play a little clip back here and you are going to see exactly how long you have, and it is quite a noticeable difference. Now in these clips, you're going to see me both using it with my attack button held down, with and without Transcendence. You're also going to see me do this with, you know, no button hitting at all and just moving around the map with and without Transcendence. And you will see that you get quite a bit more amount of Transcendence, you will get quite a bit more out of your super ability when you pop that Storm Trance. If you have Transcendence enabled, you will be able to literally go from one end of the map to the other in order to hunt down your prey. It's ridiculous. You can easily get team wipes with this and sometimes get back to their spawn and kill them again with the same super. Once you get used to moving around the maps quickly, while this is activated, you will be able to wreak havoc on an entire team with one super, almost regardless of where they are on the map. For your final column here, you have Electrostatic Mine. Storm Trance charges faster when allies are near. When Storm Trance is active, nearby enemies take damage. This is a pretty cool ability and one of my favorites to run with, as if you start off playing a little passively, you know, hang back with your team, don't go off and try to Rambo it on your own, just stay close to your team and move as a unit, you will be able to charge that super very quickly. And of course, once you have that charged and you pop it, your transcendence is going to make your super ability last forever. So this helps to very greatly increase the rate at which you'll be able to use your supers in a match. After that, we have Arc Web. Enemies damaged by your grenades chain deadly lightning to nearby enemies. This one is okay, and it is kind of a cool effect in order to make your grenades hit many more people than they normally would, but it still doesn't, you know, beat the raw power of Electrostatic Mind. Because of that, I'm gonna have to pass on this one. It's a cool ability, it is, but it just doesn't, you know, stack up to what you get off of the Electrostatic Mind. For your third ability here, you can go with Perpetual Charge. Grenade kills recharge your melee, and your melee kills recharge your grenade. This is actually what I usually will run if I'm running my Stormcaller while doing PvE activities. This allows you to almost constantly have either a grenade or a melee charge up at all times, and can really help speed up the pace in which you clear up a lot of those squishy enemies. So, if you're doing PvE, I recommend running with Perpetual Charge. If you're doing PvP of any activity, go with the Electrostatic Mind. For your armor choices, I'm not going to go into too much depth right here. You could always go with the Ram if you want to go with that just absolute maximum armor build whatsoever. Go with the Ram and don't look back. You could do a lot worse. In your arm category, you have a couple interesting options. Now, a lot of people would think to run with the Impossible Machines, because it gives you your landfall for free while you're using the Stormcaller. And while that is nice, I cannot get over using the Ophidian Aspects. Now, yes, it's true. A lot of people think Ophidian Aspects are only meant to be used with the Voidwalker because of the improved energy drain. But everything else it gives makes it worth to use. You're gonna ready your weapons quicker, you reload quicker. Everything about how you aim down sights, how you switch weapons, everything is much quicker with these equipped. It doesn't matter what gauntlets that you have, you know, what weapon you're equipping, whether it's your special weapon, your primaries, it does not matter. Everything aims down sight, readies, and switches quicker. Because of that, if you are decent and you do not need the extra little buff that you can get from like your defense on the Ram, I think these will, in the right hands, you know, a skilled shot can take full advantage of these Ophidian Aspects, and it's why they are so widely used in the higher competitive scenes, regardless of which class the Warlock is playing on. So, whether you're using your Stormcaller, you know, the Sunbreaker, it doesn't matter. These work just fine. They work, of course, very well on your Voidwalker, but they still are a completely viable option for you to use if you're running either of the other two subclasses. For the chest armor, there really isn't anything that you would want to run with the Stormcaller and the boots as well. You don't have a lot of options there. So in my mind, it's either gonna be between your Ophidian Aspects, your Impossible Machines, or the Ram. So pick your poison, see which one you like most out of that. For me, it's gonna be the Ophidian Aspects all the way. And rounding out this build, as you can see, I don't have quite the optimized stuff equipped right now, but I like to focus on my intellect and my discipline. I would like both of those to be at 300. Both of these will. I just had to switch a couple things around, and it will give me that. The reason why is because I want my supercharged quickly. That's partly what all this build is about. I want to be pumping out that Palpatine lightning as much as possible, man, and that will help me do it. Also, more grenades quicker. Why not? It's an awesome thing to have, so you might as well work on that as well. One could make the argument to go with intellect and strength as well, so you have that ridiculously long melee ability up a lot faster, and that is perfectly viable as well. Me, my playstyle, I just prefer to have my grenade and my super charge up quicker, so that's why I focus on those two stats. For the final part of this puzzle, we are going to run with the Memory of Gelion. Most of you guys who've been watching my channel know that I really like this particular artifact, as it gives you a detailed radar, and your radar persists when sighting with your primary weapons. So it gives you third eye on any primary that you're doing, plus gives you a little bit of that hunter ability, Keen Scout, where it gives you that detailed radar, helps you to more precisely pinpoint exactly where your enemies are coming from, and that can be used to great effect to give you an advantage. This is a fantastic artifact, and when you can't think of any other artifact to run, honestly, you can just run with the Memory of Gelion, and it won't let you down. You'll still get a lot of benefit from using it. All right, guys. Well, that's going to wrap it up for this build in the comment section down below. Let's go ahead and fill this up with some comments today, guys. I want to know your thoughts on this build. Also, I want you to tell me what improvements or what differences you like to do in your Stormcaller builds. There could be something that is completely viable out there that I just haven't even thought of or seen yet, and I would love to hear your guys' opinion on it. So, let's go ahead, bombard that comment section. I want to hear your ideas on the Warlock. But as always, guys, this is LV Native. You guys are awesome, and I will see you in the next one.